Those were some of Donald Trump's comments about that judge over the weekend. And sources tell CNN that Trump's message to his surrogates on a phone call was to continue the criticisms on that judge in the Trump University case, as well as the media. Let's discuss this with Steve Ford. Great to have you here on New Day.
Good to be with you, Allison.
Did you think that those comments about the judge being Mexican and about his heritage standing in the way of a good ruling on Trump University, were those racist?
Well, what they did is play in that. As the Journal pointed out the other day, you can't build a wall around Indiana.
I mean, he's American. The judge is American.
Sure it is.
He was born in Indiana. And so do you understand why those comments are seen as racist and why it's giving people pause?
What it does is sound like back off.
Okay. So given that blunder, are you still comfortable supporting him for president?
I think what it
The
key thing is, what does he do about the team in his campaign? Instead of reacting, instead of going ad hoc day to day, you need a strategy, you need a defense. And when you feel you're going to get a problem like the Trump University, you figure out how you're going to deal with it. You just don't respond off the cuff.
So, but if the election were held today, would you be comfortable voting for him?
I said it back to what's happening in the past 2 weeks when Hillary Clinton should have been on defense. Was Donald Trump on?
From Donald Trump do seem to have created a bit of a groundswell in the GOP itself about people who say that they can't support him. There's Senators Tim Scott, Senator Ben Sasse, Senators Lindsey Graham. Now, some of these were not fans to begin with, but they're being more vocal. Here is what, though, interestingly, Michael Reagan, son of President Reagan, just said about the words.
Well, this is where, again, I don't care 30 years ago in that industry, but perceptions are key in politics, and not what it is. Because
it's
screwing yourself. By the way, Ronald Reagan never made that mistake. He had made some statements that you could use against him in the 50s and 60s, and he had some crazy supporters, but he knew how to put one knows him, no. You have tens of millions of voters who are...
Thanks so much. Great to have you
Thank
on
you.
New Day. We're following a lot of news this morning, including Hillary Clinton clinching the Democratic nomination. Let's get right to it. Donald Trump reportedly overruling his staff and ordering his surrogates to continue attacks against the judge in the Trump University case. Criticism of that stance is growing even within the GOP. Listen to his former rival, Senator Marco Rubio, yesterday. Committee. Great to have you here this morning, Congressman. So it sounds like the person who you supported, Senator Marco Rubio, that is a respectful but regretful I told you so.
Well, you know,
I mean, beyond being wrong on the facts that this judge is American,
yeah.
If he were from Mexico, let's say, and had become a citizen, does that mean that he couldn't rule in any case involving Mexico? I mean, that's what people are zeroing in on, is that Isn't it racist to say that you can't do your job based on your heritage?
You can disagree on the politics of his mistake, and I think he should walk it back.
Well, he's not walking it back.
Yeah.
There was a call reportedly, and we have our sources who were on this call with his surrogates, in which he said, continue the attacks, do not apologize, continue full steam ahead. Are you comfortable, given that, are you still comfortable supporting him to be president?
Yes, oh, absolutely.
Is more than a handful now of Republicans who have publicly criticized Donald Trump over these comments. Let me just put a few up on the screen so that you can see. Times yesterday, this is the most un-American thing from a politician since Joe McCarthy. If anybody was looking for an off-ramp, this is probably it. There'll come a time when the love of country will trump hatred of Hillary. You're not there yet. That's stronger.
Well, I'm pretty vocal in saying I disagree with those comments.
So, some pundits say a peculiar campaign strategy. Why do this? Why go after the judge? Yahoo found an interview with Donald Trump's attorney from a month ago where Donald Trump's own attorney was talking in a very reasonable way about the judge, in this case's qualifications. So let me play this for you. Okay, the court's doing a good job. We have no plans to ask the judge to recuse himself. That's Donald Trump's attorney. So why is Donald Trump, do you think, doing this?
I can't answer that.
Ryan will hold his first press conference today. We suspect this will come up. What will he say about this?
I would guess that's a fair. I'm sure the speaker will get it right. Paul Ryan's very adept at this, and he is called.
Pickled now that he has said that he will support Donald Trump, and now that this has happened, how he can thread that needle?
I think you're going to.
Jason Chaffetz, thanks so much for
being
here on
Thank
New
you.
Day. Let's get over to Chris. The Trump movement is still holding out hope that an independent candidate will come forward to challenge Trump, but one top choice is saying no thank you to that offer. David French is a conservative writer for the National Review. He's a lawyer and an Iraq War veteran. And David French, Joel.
Thanks for having me.
You've had an interesting past few days.
You could say that. It has been.
So when did you decide officially not to run?
Over the weekend.
Good reasons
they
to
sound
run.
Like fantastic reasons. But the second thing I realize is, in this moment, I'm not the right person to do it. You need to have somebody with an and handle that. I mean, and so he resorts to race-based attacks. It's astonishing.
But you're making the case to run, basically. I mean, given that, isn't that a good impetus and motivation? Why not do it?
Well, you know, time's short. I think there's a number of people could fill that role. And I think the ideal person, honestly, is we've got a number of governors on the GOP side who have not. Well, in theory, yes, but
people did. So who do you think is still out there that is this sort of mythical candidate?
Well, you know, we are making some, you know, I'm on record 10 days ago or
upside down. And I do want to read something that was just published in the National Review, your magazine, about this. It's about what happened with your wife.
Mm-hmm.
And it says one Trump operative reached.
You know, I'm not going to say threatened. I don't know the answer to that question. You know, it is not something that made the decision for me. I've been against Trump for a long time. It's vibrant, and there is a path.
So the so-called Trump operative didn't send a chill through your family enough to sway you?
And not a chill enough.
As we sit here right now on this morning, do you think that there will be someone who comes forward for this third-party effort?
The honest answer, I don't know how you say and argue that that's not actually racist.
David French, great to talk to you. Thanks so much for all your candor here on New Day this morning.
Well, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Best of luck in the future. And we do want to know what your take is on this. You can tweet us at New Day or post your comment on Facebook.com/New Day. Do you think there will be a candidate who comes forward? Chris.
All right.
We're from the polling place. We want to bring in now Hillary Clinton's campaign manager, Robbie, today. Hi, Robbie.
Hello.
So last night, Hillary Clinton mathematically clinched the nomination. Why aren't you guys popping the champagne?
Well, there are six states that was a great milestone. We're on the verge of making history, and we're going to celebrate that tonight.
I mean, you say you're on the verge of making history. You have made history. I mean, within the past basically 12 or so hours in the first 240 years of this country, she's become the first woman of a major party to get the nomination. Doesn't that require some acknowledgement this morning? I mean, I know that you guys are being mum.
Well, we're going to celebrate. Really excited about that.
Is part of your reticence to celebrate that California is very close and that Bernie Sanders might win California, so you don't want to get out ahead of yourself?
Well, all these
agrees with you that we're jumping the gun, basically, in the media. So here's what he has said. It is unfortunate that the media, in a rush to is basically saying there, doesn't matter what happens today, we're going to the convention, and it's not over till it's over in the superdelegates vote. Do you agree with that timeline?
Well,
you're not going to have a nominee till the convention.
Well,
and Bernie says the superdelegates have to vote. I mean, he has said that all along. So what happens if he, let's just play hypothetical. If he wins California, and the polling there is very close, what if he says that Hillary Clinton is not the nominee and it's not going to happen until the convention?
Well, I don't want to fix it.
What will be Bernie Sanders' role if, in fact, Hillary Clinton does announce that she's the nominee tonight or tomorrow?
I think Sanders has done to our values and to our security, and I know that he is going to be in.
And between what he said in the morning about this is going all the way to the convention and then what he said in the early evening, and there was a phone call with President Obama in between those two speeches. Is President Obama pressuring Bernie Sanders to get on board and unify the party behind Hillary Clinton?
Do
Senator Sanders?
They've spoken a lot, obviously.
Stuff about what's next.
I'll leave their private conversations to themselves. But again, I am completely confident that fall.
One of the things that Bernie Sanders has been very good at is inspiring his followers with a message of excitement. I mean, you see his rallies and he's always talked about that. Hillary Clinton has been lately talking about how bad Donald Trump is. What will be her message to excite people after tomorrow?
Well, as you said, opportunities we have as a country. We can provide health care for everybody. We can make sure that families can afford college.
Nancy Pelosi just endorsed Hillary Clinton this morning, and she also sort of dropped a hint of who she'd like to see as her vice president. So let me play that moment for you. Possible there will be a two-woman ticket.
First of all,
to talk to you.
Thank you so much
for being here on New Day. Let's get over to Chris.
Back to the other side.